I didn't choose to sing in phonetic. It just came out of myself. So it became like a really huge freedom to me. I create a lot of a really strong connection with that. Each gig, it's a different experience to sing the song. So it's amazing for me. It's really a spiritual journey.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, we're here with Selma Moese, Mike Steller. We're in Lisbon right now. We're here as part of WOMEX, and we're also doing some things and creating opportunities to share music and sound and art from this beautiful city of Lisbon, this beautiful country of Portugal. And as always, we're talking about a little bit about the past. We're talking a lot about the present, but we're also focusing on the future. And we've had a really interesting experience where you created your own sound, you created your own performance, you created, in a sense, your own language. And as we're exploring these different traditions, you have to think about where they originated and how they came from. And they didn't come like A, B, C. It kind of like just manifested, and it worked. And what you did worked.
Oh, thank you. I mean, I'm lucky, I guess. Yeah.
No. Yes, you are. You are lucky.
Yeah.
But it becomes interesting when Mike, you told me about Surma, I was like, okay, let's hear this thing. And he was very, very complimentary. So that's great.
Oh, thank you.
As Mike was with you. And this was beautiful.
Yeah.
And you two are going to be working on a project together, or have worked on a project
true.
Together.
I think you have this this body language, this language of your own, that for me, it's really very spiritual. So I'm a fan of Surma. I'm going to ask you, because as a singer, when you asked me, like, do you want to do a duet? I was like, sure, I do, because I'm not the kind of singer that likes a song like A, B.
Yeah, same.
And for me, as someone that comes from a spiritual background, mm-hmm. when I join you, it's like this very spiritual moment.
Yeah.
But I don't know if you feel that.
I felt the same thing.
Is it a spiritual experience for you to do music?
Oh, yeah. It is a lot of a spiritual experience for me. Yeah, I mean, when I just enter in the stage, I feel like my body just go out of myself. So it's kind of a weird thing to explain that in words. But I mean, I just can't explain that. I just enter like in a different bubble. And when I just get off the stage, my head was so drained. And I mean, sometimes I feel dizzy. Yeah, when I get off the stage. So it is a really intense spiritual experience. Yeah. With no doubt.
And the language that you use, is it part of the process, not having something that it's very, very straight? You're a misfit.
I am.
In the most positive way.
In the most positive way, of course.
I love that word. Yeah, I'm proud of it. And I mean, I didn't choose to sing in phonetic. It just came out of myself. So it became like a really huge freedom to me. I create a lot of a really strong connection with that. I don't want to write a lyric just to, just write a lyric, and didn't feel connected with it. So when I just came to the studio and sing the melody without the lyrics, it's a new world to me. And it's 100% freedom to me. And when I just write the words and the lyrics, I just can't feel it. I just can't feel it. And in each gig, it's a different experience to sing the song. So I love that. And I mean, I have a really amazing team with me that let me do it. So it's amazing. It's amazing for me. And it's really a spiritual journey to sing with phonetics.
Which is interesting, because we were just commenting that I got to know of you through a cover song you did, six, 7 years ago. I don't know.
It's true.
So you started from a conventional structure.
Yeah.
And for me, it's been amazing to see you evolve into this persona that is always changing, always complexifying things.
Yeah.
So how does that work?
I mean,
how do you challenge yourself? How do you find your path
That's
through this?
I mean, I inspire myself a lot in the silence of the thing. So I'm trying to absorb every single second of the day in a silent mood when I'm just recording stuff. And I listen to a lot of stuff, like Japanese soundtracks, country music. It's my mainly sort of thing. Jazz music, like Duke Ellington, is like my master of it. So I just kind of mix all of the influences together and just came out of the box. So it's kind of a weird thing to explain that.
Because every record you put out, there's always something new, that you're always in a constant mutation.
It's like the right word.
And you even did something in between this. You were part of Eurovision. You made a song for Eurovision, and
that's
you should have you should have seen that, Derek. She just transformed herself.
Oh yeah.
She's
you're very
she really likes challenges and to push herself.
But yeah, I love that. But I don't like to label myself or to fit in like in some box or anything like that. And I love to challenge myself like every day, every single day. And why not? I mean,
how does your Portuguese identity play in your music and who you are?
Oh, a lot. I mean, first of all, that towel is from my grandma. For my grandma, it's like, I don't know, 50 years or something. A lot. I mean, Fado influenced me a lot, like since I was a little kid. My mom loved that. And I guess it's in our blood, so yeah. Yeah, it inspires me a lot, like the emotion of it and the mysterious way of Fado. It's a really, like the emotional thing, it's the most influence to me in my music. But I guess all of it, even the food inspires me. So I guess all of the Portuguese roots inspire me a lot, like in every single way.
É um pouco tudo
e lá está, inspiro muito também nas culturas de fora e a viajar muito também é uma coisa que me traz coisas muito bonitas à minha música e pessoas diferentes, também me inspira muito nesse aspecto.
Eu sei que tu não gostas de rótulos, não é? Mas tu és uma miúda do campo.
Sim.
E vais ajudar os teus pais muitas vezes na loja. Fazes parte da comunidade LGBT, és uma mulher, és instrumentista, são obviamente rótulos. Mas como é que tu enquadras isso no facto de seres portuguesa também? Como é que tu te vês no tempo que nós estamos a viver hoje? Achas que só por si isso é alguma coisa que seja uma mensagem? Porque às vezes, eu lembro-me de uma vez de alguém me perguntou: ai, como é que tu te sentes a ser a única mulher negra, africana, a estar nesta programação? E eu fiquei ofendida, que eu disse: não, eu espero que estar aqui porque sou uma boa cantora. No entanto, eu sei que eu, ao estar num determinado lugar, enquanto mulher, negra, africana, mãe, eu estou a representar algo e estou de alguma forma disruptiva, a quebrar assim alguns paradigmas. Eu gostava também de perceber, enquanto portuguesa, da aldeia, mulher, instrumentista.
Sim.
Que é que...
Lá está, eu sou um bocadinho como tu, essa parte da representação, não é? Eu não gosto muito de ver nesse papel de estou a representar o quê? Não é não gostar, mas não acho que não tenho essa força ou essa, sei lá, importância de estar a representar tantos temas num só, não é? Mas é aquilo que estás a dizer, acho que é importantíssimo. Por exemplo, quando perguntam o que é ser mulher na música. Não é ser mulher, nós somos pessoas iguais a todos, não é? E lá está, é uma pergunta muito sensível nesse aspecto. E ter vindo da aldeia e fazer parte da comunidade LGBT, lá está, é uma coisa que não é vista com muito bons olhos ainda em Portugal e temos um caminho ainda muito grande a percorrer, mas acho que já estamos muito melhores, não é, nesse aspecto. O mínimo que podemos fazer, acho que ajuda. E essa representação... quanto mais melhor e sinto-me muito, muito feliz por fazer parte de
às
tudo
vezes
isso.
Basta ser, não é?
Basta estar. E é sem sombra de dúvida aquilo que tu acabaste de dizer. É basta estar no momento certo, à hora certa, para representar um diverso tema. Mas lá está, é uma pergunta muito sensível. É complicado responder a isso. Mas,
respondeste?
Sim, mas pronto. É.
Já respondeste?
Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe, and we'll be back here again. Appreciate your time.
Tinder call you, feel so yeah, Tinder.